Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. You ever had a headache before, or headaches? You understand how debilitating it can be, either short-term for a couple hours, a day, sometimes days and weeks. Medically, sometimes we're giving medications that can maybe minimize them, sometimes help, temporarily give us relief, but our quality of life never really increases. In this talk that I go over with this workshop, exactly what your symptoms mean, may it be nausea or fatigue, pressure, or other things too you may be feeling, what type of headaches they can be. Then you can understand actually how to treat that not only medically, but also on your own, even with lifestyle changes too, either reduce those headaches or even delete them from your life completely. So enjoy the talk, my friends. Again, the show notes has links to the overall podcast as on YouTube, on our YouTube channel, as podcast Apple apps too, or other podcast apps that you may have, along with previous podcasts too. So enjoy the talk, my friends. Have a great week, and I'll see you next week. You're on my payroll. All right. Talk today is headaches. Boom, I'll have the flyer in the show notes afterwards for one too. I broke it down this way instead of what you feel and what it means and how to fix it. Okay, that's what it comes down to. So the first we have here is pain tension on one side of the head. Not both sides, one side of the head. And why do they say that? Usually migraines are both cranial nerves from the brain and also nerves from your spine. So you can have different symptoms. And symptoms of a migraine are really hypersensitive, as you see in the show notes too, to light, sound, taste, feeling for one too, even vision. A lot of your cranial nerves control your five senses, your vision, your smell, your taste, your hearing, all that. When someone has migraines, you ever know someone has migraines, someone before, they want to go to a dark room, they sometimes feel nauseous, they want low light, low sound for one.
I'm really enjoying
it. Cool, perfect, grab a seat. So a lot of it is when you have that sensation, you want to figure out what the trigger might be as a chiropractor. What triggers someone's migraine? Maybe a long flight, maybe stress in their life for one too, maybe something they ate. Grab a seat, wherever you want to sit, grab a seat, grab a chair. At that point, when you have that, then you grab one of the forms if you want to. There you go. And once you have, when you have migraines, realize a lot's gonna be getting your health in order. What I mean by that is what's causing stress in your body to make your body more sensitive, your trigger being migraine. Some people have neck pain. Some people have, for example, arm pain or shoulder pain. Your symptoms of higher stress to your body is going to be sometimes a migraine. I had a patient, was it Rachel or Amy? She had a family history of migraines from her mom, and her grandmother. Because of that, she had to really, really dial in her stress level and activity level. Thank you.
Yeah.
In a sense where she started doing yoga every day, exercising every day, finding a way to de-stress her body and mind every day too. So you have to be more conscious when you have migraines of different stresses in your life to make your body more flexible, even eat better too, because sometimes food that may not affect me may affect you if you have migraines. If you realize when you have your all your senses are affected by causing a migraine, you have to watch everything, what you eat, how you exercise, how much stress you have in your life for one too, because it's controllable. If you see your doctor, one of the things your doctor can tell you when you have migraines, it's hereditary. Your mom had it, your parents had it, blah, whatever. Instead of saying, I don't know, most doctors and chiropractors would rather give you an excuse that you're having a migraine versus finding the cause. And really that's the bigger thing is, how do you change your lifestyle with a migraine to make sure our lifestyle isn't affecting our body to cause your symptom of nausea, light sensitivity, whatever it might be, all right? So any questions about migraines? I had someone, Carrie, she's been a patient forever with UPS. When she has migraines, she throws up violently. Like it's like she's an exorcist on steroids. She's crazy. Because she understands her triggers though too. And she does get the shots, she has other things too, but she's trying to find a way. We help, as a chiropractor with migraines, we help control the frequency and intensity of the migraines. So you want to make sure we're doing enough to see them so the intensity doesn't knock. Because once you start throwing up from migraine, your whole day's shot. You're not gonna eat all day, you're gonna maybe stay hydrated. It may take a whole day just to recover. So can we see the signs that you can see the signs of maybe tension on one side of the head, other signs too, then realize your body's your body, big picture. Your body's your body. Can you figure out your signs that you're gonna have that may trigger a headache or a migraine or the other ones we talk about too? What are your signs, okay? Other one is now pressure, tight band around the entire head, such as someone has, not just one side.
Okay.
Those are tension headaches. It can be caused from certain things, sometimes a lack of sleep, sometimes what we ate for one too. Overall fatigue is usually the cause. When it says hormonal on there too on the forms, it's really chronic stress, even pregnancy also. When someone's pregnant, I can't empathize with pregnancy myself, but the hormones do have to rebalance themselves having a baby. That is a stress to the body that can cause the body to go fight or flight, cause the stress hormones, cortisol, catecholamines to increase, causing your stress, your relaxed hormones to decrease. When someone has tension headaches, can cause a lot of that sense. Well, my sense, when I interview someone with tension headaches, I go, how do you feel? How do you sleep? How's your stress throughout the day? Has it changed? So if they say, I don't sleep very well, I feel like the things that I have my normal environment normally, say a month ago, now seem stressful to me. Their body can no longer handle that stressors of their life. Their body become less tolerant to those stressors. That'll cause tension headaches and sense of tension headaches, because these will be your sign that my body's being too tight. My body can't relax itself. It can't go to relax, it stays in a stress state or a fight or flight state all the time. Okay? Next one is, I'm gonna go through these kind of quick because I wanna go through more exercise afterwards too, is sharp on and off pain one side of the head in around the eye. Okay? That's a cluster headache as it's defined here. I'm gonna go over more what that means. A neurological problem meaning brain or the spine where it's pinching, causing that pinch in the neck or the shoulders, even the head, to run to the head, radiate to the head, radiate sometimes to the face, sometimes down the front of the chest, shoulder, arm, even upper back here too. That's a nerve pinch, which if it's a nerve in the spine, chiropractors, that's what we treat. Just grab a seat, sign if you want to. So the sharp pain, the cluster headache is number 3 down here. So we can treat that in the sense where it's mechanical injury to your spine, we can treat to make that overall calm itself down. So number 1 and 2 are more lifestyle. Stress in the overall person, overall body for 1 and 2. Sometimes, like with the migraines, sensitivities, there are things too. But number 3, the cluster headaches, the sharp on and off pain, is more of something happened, an injury to your body. Accident a couple years ago. You change your work about more sitting. Bad posture for 1 also too. So can we fix that 1 over time, then help you over a period of, say for example, once it calms down, readjust your sitting, your posture, even your lifestyle, to make them not come back again. Those are more controllable more than other things, than based on causing injury point, fix the injury, the cluster headaches, then calm itself down again, all right? Next one, neck and back pain, neck and back of the head pain and pressure, okay? That's called cervicogenic, so I'm gonna show you real quick here. What that means is back here, behind the ear is your suboccipital area back there, okay? If I thought about it, I would have shaved my neck for you guys today because I'm that dedicated to all of you, okay? Kidding. Especially on 1 side. So here is your suboccipital area. That first bone of the spine is underneath the skull. So we have to do is when we adjust that or move that, get that to unlock to make that nerve that goes from here, the head down the shoulder, down the back, to make that unlock and then make sure our muscles stay loose. What makes these muscles tight to make those nerves want to pinch is doing this. Got to keep our body up and back as much as we can. I'll go over that in the second sitting posture checklist, so our body doesn't want to tighten itself up. If you computer work all day long, not only doing this, we're also doing this, to make our overall body tighten up even more. What happened during COVID? A lot of people worked from home. Sat all day. Didn't move enough. So they went from here all day long to like, bye-bye, punching. So you gotta get our body back here. So let's go over that real quick. I'm gonna have you do is sit in your chair. Put in your chair, sit in the first third of your chair, more upright. Everybody participate if you can. So scoot more forward. Where's more? Right there. I want you to look in the edge, okay? By doing that, then bring your knees below your hips. Let me back the camera up a little bit.
So people can see later.
Bring your knees below your hips and feet underneath you, either in the middle or if you're comfortable like me, on the outside. By doing that, then your back will naturally arch forward and your body will sit back more on your hips than on your tailbone. Does that feel easier to lean back more this way? So can I more forward? What's your name?
Robin.
Tony, nice to meet you. And then now, this is gonna feel a little off balance. Bring your feet, actually for yours, bring your legs behind, on the outside for a better balance. And then bring them behind you like I'm here. How does that feel? Weird? Good. And make sure your low back contract a little bit. So the low back contracts, it actually makes your body here, makes it pull backwards more. These will pull down to allow your whole body now to shift backwards. If you're shifting backwards, then your shoulders have to naturally drop so you don't fall forward. I'm trying to get the body to reset its balance point here. So by doing this, when I stand up, I'm gonna stand this way, shoulders drop backwards instead of being hunching forward. That's the plan. It takes time to change. Your brain is where a lot of that balance is, your cerebellum. There's no test over about the names. Your cerebellum back here, that controls your balance. By doing this more and more over time, it'll be an unconscious position, your default position, so this statue feels bad again. Don't let it give patience, the sitting posture checklist. It's like this again, body back on the edge of the front of the chair, knees below the hips, feet underneath you, so you have to balance on our hips to lean back so don't fall forward and embarrass yourselves.
That feels good.
Yes, over time it feels good. Then now from there we stand up also the same way, back, you don't have to stand up this way, so now it weights on our heels too, because it feels more natural. And our muscles will adapt, so by doing this, our hips have less pressure here, less back pressure, less neck pressure, and our body can sit back, head back. You take the pressure out that top sub-occipital area back here while that tension occurs, causing that cervicogenic type of neck-related headache. Boom. I did my homework. I studied for this class today. All right? Questions?
Is that how you should sit when you're working on a computer?
Exactly. Back here. So again, adjusting your computer screen up here. I'm here working this way. And when you get tired, if I get tired, what I do, it's cheat, my hack, is I bring my foot forward. Take a break for a second, feels okay, and switch sides. Your problem is sitting in a car all day, a guy who drives to work every day, hour and a half. Horrible. For me, that'd be nightmare. But it's his work requires him to sit in the car. So he's like this. There's nothing you can really do. So if I have to drive long distance, I'm gonna put a pillow behind me so I keep my upper body upright. What I can. If I'm gonna drive too, on my feet even, not my foot over here, my foot out the window, not leaning this way. No, keep your feet even as much as possible. The reason my feet are even, and then my hips are even also. If my feet are off, my hips then shift. So much as you can, when we're sitting or standing or driving, feet even, here, if possible, but not here. I'm cool enough, I don't have to put my foot back here. You know what I mean? Questions? Any yet?
Question, can some of these positions cause a numbness in your lip?
Yes, because numbness in your lips comes from a genital nerve and from your neck, from your brain even too, that allows it to come around this way on the side of the jaw. You have trigeminal nerve 1, 2, and 3 that runs to the jaw causing numbness. Unless you have teeth issues too, it can be internal. But if it's coming just there, so look at the neck and see if that works, pitch in that area. People come in my office with just eye pressure. I have Marilyn comes in once every 2 weeks for eye pressure. I saw him come in, Tim, same thing. He comes in, he knows his neck is pinched when his eyes feel like there's a lot of pressure. But again, once you understand your symptoms of type of headaches you have or pressure, which is really the biggest thing, adapt when you know how to fix it. So with headaches too, the fix with this number 4 cervicogenic headaches, cervicogenic, is not only, we do the adjustments in our office, that's what we do, we unlock the nerve, but also if you feel that, ice the neck down. When I say ice the neck down, it's not going to be here, down here, be more up here across your ears. You want to get underneath that skull to cause the pressure release that way. You want to go high enough on that. All right. Questions about number 4, cervicogenic headaches. Something you can fix really on your own long term by having better posture, if you're comfortable, even making the muscles stronger back here. So the guy who has to drive an hour and a half every day, I have the exercise for his lower back. So he stays strong, doesn't weaken out at the end of the day. That's the plan. Alright. So Robin number five. We've done number five. Basically, these exercises to calm things down, again, especially number one and two, are going to be overall stress relief and how to get your overall body better, also improving diet, but also increasing mobility. That's the key. So I'm going to give you one here. What's your name again?
Betty,
come on over, Betty. Grab a seat for me.
Okay.
She's my Vanna White for the afternoon. All right. So, Betty, I want to do is make these muscles here stretch from the base of your neck to your shoulder, to your upper back. So have you turn a little bit more, turn more this way.
Does that help for stress too?
Exactly, helps stress also too.
It's very stressful.
You're a happy, stressful person. So here, Betty, what I'm gonna do is make this muscle stretch from here, it's called the upper trap muscle, attached from the base of the skull where the cervicogenic kinetics occur, down your shoulder and down your upper back. What I wanna do is bring your right hand behind your left ear, and Betty, turn your head exactly like that, perfect. Now head down toward your body. It's called the upper trap stretch, my trademark, just like that. Where do you feel that stretch?
In the neck.
Here?
Right there.
Yes, the belly of the muscle here is where it should feel. Sometimes you feel at the base of the skull, sometimes the shoulder blade back here. All right, so stay there for 1 second, don't move, hold it right there.
Shoulder
stretching. Oh. There.
He's got the
lift.
That's the.
Oh, gosh.
Wow.
Torture.
Wow.
There we go. So that this muscle here. Alright, there we go. Alright, now we're going to switch sides. So I'm going to have that. You do good. There we go. Turn your head to the shoulder. There we go. Make sure looking our head goes toward, we're gonna point our nose toward the same shoulder we're working. So right now Betty's working the right shoulder. So relax shoulder.
I'll tell you that is really stressful.
It's tight. If we can relax the upper trap muscles, then our shoulders can sit backwards, take the stress off of overall neck, helping relieve the headaches, even neck pain.
I don't get headaches,
but yeah, calm things down.
Yeah,
tightens everything up. All right, good job. Thank you, Betty. Thank you. Grab a seat. Does that make sense? You guys doing a good job. Good. Woo! Woo! That's fun, isn't it?
Hey.
That's more lower back and hip. So sitting better will help that sciatica too. So anytime you have nerve pain, maybe pain down the arm or down the leg, sciatica, or even down the hip, you want to ice it, no heat. Ice the lower, for sciatica, you want to ice the lower back right about here. For about 15 minutes lying down to get that inside nerve and disc to calm itself down and deflame and calm the nerve. Yeah, it's fun. Hit all day long, that's what I did. All right. Another one here too. Move the camera a little bit. I want you to use at home, whatever you have at home, a broomstick, a stick, whatever you have, a Swiffer. I want you to try this too. Is taking that stick, and what happens is your shoulders get real tight on both sides. We do this. You gotta get our body back. So you wanna start doing this, is just stretching them out a little bit. Back and forth. Alright? If you can, come all the way back. We're just a little bit too short for me. And hold that position right there and come forward. So coming back, hold. I would do this maybe for 5 seconds. Hold. Go to one side. Hold. Other side. Hold. Alright. Rob, wanna try this? Wanna try? No? Want to try it? Yeah. This is an interactive class. I'm signing the door. It's an interactive class.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes. Everyone's taking their turn.
Okay.
All right. So here we're going to come back, straight back as far as you're comfortable. Head up the whole time. Go to one side for 5 seconds, and then Rob the other side by 5 seconds. All right. Let's see how that feels for you. Straight back. Hold. Is she making the face?
No, not yet.
All right. How's that feel? Feels okay.
It's okay.
And then go to one side. As far as you can, feel that stretch in the shoulder and upper back. And then other side. What side feels tighter when you go side to side?
This side.
Yeah. Yeah. Mine's the left one, but yours is more that side.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got it. Look, hold them both sides for 5 seconds, about 3 times.
Get all things up. I hear everything pop.
There you go. Self-chiropractic care. Boom.
Right.
I'll bill you later.
Okay.
All right. All right.
Yeah. I think I'm excellent here.
There you go. This I can do all day long. Morning, I recommend morning and night for my patients.
Okay.
But to calm things down, help our bodies sit up better, get things looser so it can sit back.
Okay.
All right. See, look. See, it wasn't too bad demonstrating today.
Not bad enough.
See?
Thank
you, famous, okay?
Thank you.
You got it. Any questions?
Let's skip to the first one, migraine. What do you think of Botox?
I've heard it helps temporarily.
Temporarily.
The problem is it's not a fix. So if someone has severe migraines, like I mentioned with Carrie, my patient who throws up all the time, she'll get a Botox shot once a month. She'll take medication sometimes daily basis. But it's something to where can you find, and she does, because her lifestyle is up and down, just crazy sometimes. Can you find things in your life so you can change to eat healthier, have less stress, exercise a little bit more, and exercise not overdoing it, but enough to where you feel like your body's staying strong for your work, for your day, whatever it might be. Migraines are tough. Migraines aren't easy to treat. And as someone who comes in for migraines and vertigo, same thing. She gets relief, then she understands, oh, I have to go back to my routine. I was out of town for a couple days or a couple weeks. I have to go back to my routine again. It's fine. It's working with a doctor that's going to help you find your routine that's worked for you to minimize the number of migraines, the intensity of them, or any headaches for one too. But once you find your triggers, what they might be, you know how to control that trigger. To at least minimize how often you get them. All right.
Why do some people get
them? It's not hereditary, but it's something to where you have that sensitivity to either light, sound, taste, or smell, like there's one of the symptoms too. But it's your body has a tendency to have it. And there is, I'll give you retropone, yes, but it's controllable by your environment. You have to be more sensitive of what you do in your environment, what you eat, what kind of stress you're under, and how much you exercise.
I totally
agree. Yeah, I've set up a patient who came in later on, where her mom, she had it, her mom had it, her mom, grandmother has it too, but because she was able to diagnose what the problem was with her lifestyle, she gets her really minimized. Very rare she gets them.
I never had one, but I don't get them.
You don't want to go to a dark room, you feel like you're throwing up all the time, you feel nauseous all the time. You don't want to drink water, you're just shut down for the day.
But I think lifestyle is critical.
Huge, huge, huge.
Especially in today's age where we're getting bombarded with all this junk.
Every age is always the worst. It's always worse than it was before. But that part of it, I'll give you that. But it's something to where when you have that sensitivity, you have to be more careful. If someone has back surgery, you have to be more careful with what they do. They can still feel less symptoms, they can feel good, but it takes more effort to get themselves healthy. That's sciatica. Okay, how do you fix it? Then to make sure our body doesn't go back again by doing the right things lifestyle-wise to keep your body loose and strong. You have to stay flexible and strong. Again, what I tell patients, for your lifestyle, for your work, for your daily routine, we all have to take care of our bodies. You know, but the problem is we don't take care of our bodies. We wait to take care of our bodies until we have a problem. We go, okay, now do I find help? Once you find the help, then changing your lifestyle allows you to keep that problem coming back.
I think it is a lifestyle.
That's a good theory. You got to put in practice. I go to the gym every morning at 5:30. That's my job. That's my home. That's my routine so I can do this all day. Eat lunch, take a power nap, and go back to work again. Boom. We have to stay healthy to do that. And my partner, he met with someone and he said, because our job is very physical. As a chiropractor, we see a lot of people. How long can you use for physically? Not very long if you don't keep yourself healthy. So you have to keep yourself healthy and keep your body moving for your work, your environment, your lifestyle. Mine is pushing people around all day. So I do. And I have fun doing it too. It entertains me. All right. Anything else?
So one last. You can't inherit this.
Yes, there is, but it's minor versus lifestyle.
Minor.
Because what happens when you go to get your doctor about migraines, what do they do? It's the first thing they do. get the script up. There you go. Okay, you're taking this tomorrow. This for the rest of your life. If it doesn't help, we'll give you Botox shots. Give you shots in your neck, shots in your head. And the reason is because they're not looking for the cause of the migraines. Looking to help make you feel better by a drug. I mean, it's nothing wrong with that. But if you're more proactive about your health, how do you feel better by finding the cause of the problem? And from there, okay, I may take those drugs to get a shot once in a while, but not all the time. Like I said, once someone came in earlier, your friend, and I get the shots, doesn't help. You keep going back, it's finding something different to do. Because the problem is the migraines, headaches, your quality of life goes from 100% to 80, sometimes zero for the day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. No one wants to look down here. You have to do something different to actually change what you're doing, either through medications, through chiropractic, through lifestyle, to make sure your body can change over time. You have to be proactive. Healthcare is healthcare, but it's not your care sometimes. It's how to take care of your body. By being proactive, doing these classes, educating people, learning from different things, that how to take care of my body, because my body is different than everybody else. Everyone's genetic makeup is different. So how does yours different than mine? It may not be as humorful, but that's just, everyone's different. Yes, ma'am.
Some people say CBD.
If it's gonna help relax your body, help relax your nerves, your muscles temporarily, not a bad thing temporarily. Is that better than medication? Maybe. Some people say CBD has less side effects. I have to say some people say, because it's true. If it helps, it helps people, it doesn't help people. So it helps you, it helps you.
Now, is CBD marijuana, is that different?
There's different components of it. HTC is the marijuana, the high component. There's also other components too that are more the health benefits than the high component. And because it's so prevalent now, people can want to consume it more for the medical benefit. There's more companies out there selling for the medical benefit. It does work. If it didn't work, people wouldn't want to buy it. It's not the vape, it's not cigarette smoke, it's not the nicotine, it's not that, it's more of getting the medical benefit from that component of this of the marijuana seed or plant.
So what is it?
It's not, it's HTC is one of them, the second one, so I can't remember off the top of my head. THC.
So that can be found in your blood test.
That can be found, but yes. Yeah. So that it would be part of your, it would, once you take it, you'll see in your blood for a couple of days, maybe a week or so.
Really?
Yeah. It's like any type of drug. You take blood pressure medication, you take the blood test, they can test for it if you have blood pressure medication in your blood.
Do the ointments have that in it?
Not necessarily, but it does because it goes through your skin. Your skin is absorbable. Especially under your armpits, your groin area where it's thinner skin. That's where they have, for example, male testosterone cream, estrogen cream, hormone cream. I put it underneath your armpits and also your groin because it's thinner tissue.
Yep. That's the testosterone cream. I didn't know there was such a thing.
As a cream, they do prescribe for some people.
For
some people would rather, ideally, what's more compliant is people take the pill instead, because it's a pill. They forget that the deodorant stick at home, whatever it might be. So the compliance is part of it too. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, CBDs, everyone, if it works for you, it works for you. Based on like, I took this, like, if it works, it works. Any side effects? Well, you gotta listen to your body. Any side effects I had from that too? Because I don't know. Everyone's different. Again, do what works for your body. But find out what it is first of all. Okay, what's going on with it? Get it diagnosed properly. Then go. Okay, what? How do I want to treat it? If the medication isn't working for me. All right. Anything else? Good. Next month is. I don't know either. Something important. We can have it up front. It'll be in the newsletter. It'll be in the newsletter, or what do you find in the magazine? Is it a monthly magazine they have it too?
There's a month, yeah.
Okay. It's somewhere posted somewhere.
They haven't done October yet.
I do October and I do November, but I don't do December. Because it's the holidays. And I'm usually on vacation.
We're closed anyway.
Good. So see, I can't. I was going to, but you guys are closed.
We're closed.
Thanks for watching. Mm-hmm.